In the last episode, we learned how to generate mesh in Unreal Engine, and in this episode, we will create a flat terrain and play with its heights a little bit. Let's get started!
Firstly, we need to create a grid of vertices. Let's go to Visual Studio. Now we need to move all the variables except material to the private section because we don't need to set them manually anymore. And also, let's remove U properties. Then we should create create vertices function and let's declare it in CPP file. Number of vertices depends on our grid size, so let's add variables responsible for it. Now we have to create each vertex individually. In order to do this, we need to iterate through all vertices and assign location to them. So we should create for loop with variable x. But you see here that to create a grid of two squares, we need three vertices. Because of that, I use less or equal operator, so that I am creating proper amount of vertices. Then we create nested for loop that will iterate through y coordinate, and inside this loop we add this code. Also, let's create new variables called scale and uv scale and multiply each coordinate by them. Scale is like a gap between coordinates, and without scale our grid will be too small. Also, I will draw spheres to show that our vertices were generated. Now let's call our function on beginPlay and go back to Unreal Engine. Run live coding. I will set our x size to 5, y size to 10, scale to 100 and UV scale to 1. I hit play. And our vertices were generated. Now we need to create triangles, so we should create a new function. Then let's create a first triangle. It starts from 0, the next vertex is 1, that is 0 plus 1, and the last vertex is 4, that is y size plus 1. Let's do this in code. Oh, and of course here we should use UV scale instead of scale. Return to Unreal again, live coding. Hit play, and here is our first triangle. To create the second triangle, we need to take vertex 1, then vertex 5, that is y size plus 2, and vertex 4 equals to y size plus 1. So let's do this in code. Go back to editor, and our second triangle was successfully created. Now we need to generate these triangles for each square. To do this, we have to iterate through each vertex. Let's start by creating only the first row. So we should create for loop with y variable that keeps going until y is less than y size. Then we copy all this code inside the loop, create variable called vertex outside of the loop, set it to 0, add it to index of each point, and increment it by 1 in the end of the loop. Let's check the result. And yes, this works perfectly. It's really important to use less operator instead of less or equal. Let me show what happens when we use less or equal. It looks that everything is okay, but if I try to go down here, something blocks me. And if I go under our terrain, you will see that strange rectangle. So basically it happens because when our loop reaches the value of 3, it creates two triangles using these points. Therefore, we need to use less operator so that our loop doesn't reach the value of 3. Then we create another for loop with variable x also using less operator and put our previous loop inside the new one. Let's test it. And our terrain is not generated correctly. Also, we have that rectangle under our terrain again. It happens because despite the fact that we use less operator, our vertex value still reaches 3 and 7 because it increases only by 1. So we need to somehow skip these values. And probably the easiest way to do this is incrementing vertex in the end of x loop. Return to the engine, hit play, and now everything is working perfectly. The last thing we can do is playing with heights of vertices. So let's create two variables called zmin and zmax. Add u property to them and pass random value between these values to z coordinate of each vertex using fmath randrange function. Also, let me remove the bug spheres. Go back to Unreal Engine, live coding. I will set z min to -100, z max to 100, x size to 100 and y size to 75 for example. Hit play and now our terrain has random heights. Thanks for watching and see you in the next episode.